Hey guys, this is Paige from BeWoom.com, and last year Google announced a new Chromecast with the new Google TV platform. Now, a new Chromecast is fine, but what's interesting is Google TV. So Google TV is like a revamp of Android TV. It's basically an update to Android TV that brings a new UI and a new name. Well, we have the new Chromecast with Google TV set up right here. So let's take a look at the new Google TV in action. Now, first up, I want to show you this, the new Chromecast, because I think this is super cool and a solid alternative to Fire TV. Now, the design is similar to previous Chromecast, but this one has a more oval design. So this plugs into the back of the TV, so the looks don't matter. What matters is the fact that it has 4K support, support for things like Dolby Vision, Dolby Atmos, and it works very well, which you will notice in a bit. Plus, the remote is one of the best remotes I've seen, both in terms of looks as well as buttons. I mean, it looks very, very good, and the buttons are super nice. Anyway, the highlight of this new Chromecast is the new Google TV platform, so let's get into that. So to start things, let me tell you that I have been using two Android TVs at my home, and yeah, the Android TV UI does kind of look dull and boring. Now, in comparison, the Fire TV UI looks a lot nicer, but it's filled with only Prime Video recommendations, so yeah, that's not good. Well, this is where the new Google TV update comes in. Now, the first thing I liked about the Google TV is the new cool starting animation. I mean, this looks really cool, right? Now, the whole setup process has been revamped too. The setup happens via the Google Home app now, and it's pretty seamless. You scan the QR code, and it connects Google TV to Wi-Fi, signs in the Google account, and it lets you enable features like search across TV apps, set up the ambient mode, choose the apps you use, etc. So this is a more detailed setup, and it happens on the Google Home app on your phone. And yeah, I like the whole UI too. Now, once you've set things up, you get this brand new Google TV home screen. I mean, my first impressions, this looks more modern and nicer when compared to the current Android TV UI. So this is the Android TV UI right now. And now this is the Google TV UI. Looks better, right? So as you can see, there are 5 tabs here, with the For You tab being the highlight of this new UI. And rightly so, because this brings in recommendations from a lot of different apps, be it Netflix, Prime Video, Disney Plus, and a lot more. Now, I have set up Google TV with the country set to US and a VPN turned on, because this new personalized recommendations feature is only available in a few countries. So yeah, I'm not getting the right recommendations. But yeah, this gives us a good idea of the new personalized home screen. As you can see, there is a recommendation from different apps right on the top in this big card. Prime Video, Tubi, YouTube, Disney Plus, etc. Even when I scroll down below, I'm getting top picks, my apps, and then some more recommendations. There's trending on Google, dramas from different platforms, love shows, Bollywood movies, action movies, and a lot more as you scroll down. Now, I like this popular movies and shows list, which shows me the most hyped movie or show from different platforms. Now, as you can see, there are a lot more recommendations from different apps, but you can use this manage services button to disable or enable the apps you're getting recommendations from. Now, apart from this, I also noticed that you get the Rotten Tomatoes tomato meter, which is like IMDb ratings on the Fire TV sticks. So this is very useful. Plus, you can improve the suggestions here. You can press hold on any title to get these options. You can like and dislike a title to improve the recommendations you're getting, add a movie or show to the watch list, or, you know, mark it as watched. This is nice. Now, as for the other tabs, the search tab is a good addition because it gives you suggestions on how you can use the Google Assistant on Google TV. And it also lets you find something to watch through these options. Now, the movies and shows tab are again about different recommendations from different apps. The apps tab is cool too. Here you have the apps you have installed in your TV, and there are also these app categories so that you can explore new apps, or you can search for an app and install it. Now, scrolling down below, there are these different app recommendations. See, it's basically the Google Play Store in a separate tab on the home screen, which I think is a good addition. Now, the last tab is for the library, where you can see your watch list and also manage your rented shows or movies. Now, on the right edge, you get this profile icon, which is where you get the option to go to the settings or start the screensaver. And below that, you get all the notifications. Now, honestly, all of it, the new UI, the phone, the animations, everything looks more modern and cooler. And very importantly, the settings page has been revamped too. I mean, let's face it, the settings page on the current Android TV is clunky. You have to go inside each of these options to find out what settings are there. Now, on the Google TV, you get this nice dual pane design, which takes out all the pane from the settings. So basically, as you can see here, you get all the categories on the left, and on the right side, you can see what's inside those categories. Now, as I move through the settings categories on the left, the options on the right automatically update, which is nice. Now, same thing happens when I move to an option to the right. Now, the settings also have a few new handy options. There's an app-only mode which basically removes all the recommendations from the home screen and turns it into a simple UI where you only have your apps. There are also more options in the display and sound settings. Now, these might be settings just for the Chromecast, but they are interesting. So you can enable or disable HDMI CEC, which lets you, you know, control all of your devices with one remote. There's a match content option, which probably makes sure that your TV matches the dynamic range of the movie or show you're watching. There's also game mode now, and you can also choose from different screen resolutions and refresh rates. There are also more sound options. You can choose from the surround sound format manually. I mean, you can set it to automatic if you want, but you can choose from these options: Dolby Atmos, AAC, Dolby Digital, and Dolby Digital Plus. Now, apart from that, I also noticed that the remotes and accessories page now shows the battery level of the remotes. I think this is very useful. Now, below this is another interesting feature. See, if you've used Fire TV Stick, you'd know about its equipment control feature, which lets you use its remote to control soundbars and other devices. Well, Google TV brings the same feature. As you can see, it has the option to add a TV because this is a Chromecast. And you can also add a soundbar that you can control with this remote. Now, the Mi TV I'm using isn't listed, nor is the Boat or Realme soundbars that we have, so we could not test this, but this is a good feature. I just hope Google adds more manufacturers to the list. So those are all the changes that Google TV brings, and all that is great, but there's still one big feature that I personally find missing in Google TV, and that is user profiles. I mean, yes, there are user profiles in individual apps like Netflix, Prime Video, but no user profiles in Google TV means that no matter who opens up your TV, they'll get the same recommendations as you, which isn't very convenient. Anyway, one question that I have seen a lot ever since Google TV was announced is Google TV replacing Android TV? Well, the answer is no. See, Google TV is like a launcher or a UI makeover of Android TV, because as you can see here, it still says Android TV OS 10. So it is still Android TV underneath. It's not a brand new platform. But if you ask me, I would say I like the UI changes Google TV brings. I think it looks way more modern when compared to the Android TV UI that we've been using right now. And the new recommendations feature is actually something interesting because it combines multiple platforms. So I hope the new Google TV with Android TV 10 update arrives in India soon. And apart from that, I also hope that Google brings this new Chromecast in India because, like I said, this is a solid Fire TV alternative. So yeah, we need this new Google TV platform and the new Chromecast in India soon. But what do you guys think of this new Google TV UI? I want to know in the comment section below. So comment below. Also, give this video a like if you enjoyed it. Make sure to share it and subscribe to our channel for more amazing tech videos. But that's me signing off. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.